Sciences, University of Peradeniya. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to present our study on biomass fuel smoke exposure and anemia in reproductive age women in central province Sri Lanka. Currently, over half of the world continues to rely on solid fuels, including wood, animal dung, agricultural residues, and coal. Indoor air pollution from cooking and heating with such fuel is estimated to be responsible for about 1.6 million global deaths annually. So why this is an important topic in Sri Lanka? Sri Lanka is a developing country in South Asian region, which is upgraded into lower to middle income country recently. Wood is the main source of kitchen fuel in Sri Lanka, often burned over open fire in inefficient cooking stoves. Combustion of such biomass fuel can lead to emission of particulate suspended matter and also pollutant gases, including carbon monoxide. Indoor air pollution from burning biomass fuel leading to many diseases, and reproductive age women can be considered as one of the most vulnerable group who are daily exposing to biomass fuel smoke. So this study aimed to identify the prevalence of anemia and its association with biomass fuel smoke exposure among reproductive age women in central province Sri Lanka. In methodology, this is a part of ongoing large study which launched as a descriptive cross-sectional study. And sampling was done through multi-stage sampling method. And we used an interviewer-administered questionnaire for the collection of data. At the same time of administering the questionnaire, we have collected blood from each participant to assess the blood hemoglobin concentration using Drabskin Sinemet hemoglobin method. Then we classified anemia accordance with the World Health Organization cutoff values for detecting anemia among non-pregnant women. Accordingly, we define three categories of anemia as severe, moderate, and mild. So in results, we found that the overall prevalence of anemia among reproductive age women in central province as 37%, and among them 22% were mildly anemic, whereas 30% were moderately anemic. Regarding the fuel type, among all households, we found that 39.8% households were using only wood as the cooking fuel, whereas some other households were using mixed fuel types like wood plus kerosene and wood plus liquid petroleum gas. And also we found more than 25% of households were using only liquid petroleum gas, and we see it as a good indicator. And then when comparing the prevalence of anemia among different fuel type users, we found no significant difference between different fuel type users. So in conclusion, the prevalence of anemia was found to be at the level of moderate of public health significance according to the classification of public health significance issued by World Health Organization. And however, the inferences of association between the biomass fuel exposure and anemia should be confirmed with larger scale studies, as this this study is having small sample size at this stage. Thank you.